like to give you guys a little bit of advice if you're interested in getting into the area of real estate photography. Now, you may know that I've been a professional photographer for many years. I'm going to count it as over 30 years at this point. And so people have asked me, you know, what areas of photography should I get into? And there's a lot of areas you can get into. You can do forensic photography like I had done. You can do wedding photography like I had done. Or you can get into things like real estate photography. Now, real estate photography is an area that I believe is an up and growing area. There's a lot of people in photography nowadays, and if you're going to get into something, you might as well get into something that is a little bit more open. And real estate photography, I believe, is an area that is like that. It's kind of wide open at this point. So what do you need to do to get into real estate photography? First off, you need to be good in photography in general. It doesn't matter if you have the equipment but don't know how to use that equipment properly. Yeah, don't get into real estate photography. But if you know what you're doing, if you've taken classes, if you've taken some type of training in how to use your camera properly, if you know how to balance lighting from the inside and the outside, if you know all the technical ways of doing things, consider real estate photography. So what do you really need? Here's what I'm going to suggest that you need. You need a good camera, first off. You need a good tripod. You need an external flash. You're going to need an ultra wide angle lens. All right. You're going to need some type of software to process things. I suggest typically Adobe Lightroom, because you can do HDR in the Adobe Lightroom. If you want, you can use an external HDR software besides Adobe Lightroom as well. That might do better than a Lightroom program can. But in general, to process the overall quality of your photographs, something like Lightroom would be the best way to go. Okay. Can you make a lot of money in real estate photography? Yes, you can, actually. But here's the one thing I will suggest to you. If you're looking for a job from a company that will send you out to do real estate photography, it's going to be an uphill battle. There's not lots of companies out there that do that. And to try to get a job doing it is tough, all right? You could market yourself. But I've said for many years that a lot of times it's not how good a photographer you are to succeed in photography. It's how good you can market yourself. A lot of it is business related. It's not even photography related. So no matter how well you are versed in doing photography, get well versed in business. If you don't know how to run business, you're not going to be successful. Learn some sales techniques. Learn how to market yourself. Learn how to present yourself. Your job really is to convince the real estate agent that it's worth hiring you. If you can't do that, no matter how good of a photographer you are, you're going to suffer in real estate photography. So get better at sales, get better at marketing, get better at putting together your website. Do these type of things. Make sure those things are in place besides the photography end of it. I don't think a lot of photography companies emphasize this enough. I think they really only emphasize photography, but really to be good in photography, you have to be a good salesperson and you have to be a good business person, because you are actually selling your services. And if you can't do that, then really your only best bet is to work for a studio or work for another company who will do it for you. But again, those jobs are very difficult to get. I recently had a phone call from a potential student asking me about real estate photography. And she was very excited about it. She said that she had taken photography before in college and she wanted to get back into it. And I told her all the things that she needed to get. And then the minute I mentioned the fact that she had to market herself and sell her services to somebody, that's when she kind of tuned herself down. She just said, "I don't think I can do that." So for her, I told her, if you can't do that, then it's best not to get into it. Because you can spend all the money on the equipment, you can learn all the things about photography, and really never get anywhere with it if you can't market yourself or present yourself, okay? And this is true for anything. It's not just photography. If you want to get ahead in life, you're going to have to be able to convince others that it's worth hiring you. So anyways, my advice to you is get good in other areas besides the photography end of things, because you will do better in photography if you can actually sell your own services. Hey, if you like these videos, go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and hit the little bell icon, because that'll tell you when new episodes will happen. And by the way, let me mention one more time, I said this on my previous video, that subscribing to a channel does not cost you anything, all right? It just helps the YouTube creator know if he's what he's doing is good, and it also helps him in terms of monetization down the road if advertisers are looking to advertise on his channel. You will need a YouTube account or a Gmail account. So if you have a Gmail account, you can register and actually sign up with subscriptions. Without the Gmail account or some type of Google thing, it's going to be kind of hard for you to subscribe. But I do hope you do subscribe to this channel, as well as other YouTubers that you're interested in seeing. Talk to you guys next time.